seem supreme.
Yo, 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 what is good, everybody? Welcome back
2343 TV with me, GD. It all rhymes. How's everybody doing? I just hopped in the chat. What up, Simple Sam? What up, Dobsky? Dobsky? What up, Enigmatic Onion? Roger, I believe. I know. I always remember there's an O involved. I think it's Roger. If I'm wrong, maybe it's Josh. No, it's Roger. How's everybody doing? You guys ready to make some beats? Hopefully you can hear me. Let me know if you can hear me. I didn't do a test run today, so I'm just hoping that this works. So throw a emoji in the chat if you can hear me. Yeah, I actually put in a lot of work on Josh. Oh man, I'm gonna keep calling you Roger. See, that's what you gotta just make your artist name Josh Onion, or like Enigmatic Onion parentheses Josh or something. do whatever you want. I said Josh is my second guess, right? Yeah. I thought Roger both times. What up, Simple Sam? And Simple Sam is Martin. So it's like, you guys' names are just so random. But you never know, man. Just do whatever you want. So I put in a lot of work on that track from last week. But first, before I get started, I want to keep working on that same beat from last time, because I think it's turning into something really cool. Which is cool, because I love when that happens, when you like make a beat for something like this, like a class or a stream. And then, like, honestly, like, half the music I put out starts like that. So something about, like, the pressure of writing in front of people, it just helps a lot. So maybe, like, when you guys are at home or working with, you know, other artists, you know, like, try that, you know, try to produce in front of someone, like, while they're watching. And, you know, it might be a little stressful, but I think it kind of helps you push through the bad ideas faster, and you kind of get to, like, the point faster. So, yeah, I think it's always... it works out a lot for me. So, Roger Matic Onion. See, now you're going to confuse me. Now I'm going to keep calling you Roger. Before we get started, I just want to remind you guys, I think they put it in the chat, but 343 is running a Cyber Week sale for 25% off all of the courses until this Sunday, December 5th. And they're doing a giveaway for 343 TV, which is what you're watching right now. And it's for a 3-month membership to Splice. So, you know, that's pretty tight. Splice has a lot of cool stuff that you could get for free for 3 months. So, definitely look into that. And yeah, I'll remind you guys again, maybe when some new people show up, and make sure you guys take advantage of that stuff. But let's get to work. Yeah, this is the beat I started last week. And I think, you know, I kind of got to the point where... you know, I made some like future bassy type stuff, but for me, like, that's just never really enough. Like, I think that it's been done to death. Like, when you drop into a track and it's just, I don't know. Like, for me, it's like, you know, future bass as a genre is like already kind of, I don't know, been around for a while now. So I think if you're going to do it, which I like doing it, I like making future-based stuff, but if you're going to do it, you got to have more going on than just that. So that's what I started to do kind of this week, was like start to layer more things on top, like a lead. So let's just see what it sounds like right now. Let me know if you guys can hear this, if it sounds okay. We'll be right back. Yeah, really, really feeling this chord progression. I feel like it's one of my most, like, I don't know, newest things that I've made that sounds, like, very interesting. I love, you know, sorry, I kind of have, like, a cough today. You know, like, when it comes to chord progressions, it's, like, there's nothing really out there that hasn't been done in terms of, there's nothing out there that hasn't been done, like, you know, music's been around for ever, and there's only 12 notes on a piano, right? So pretty much everything that can be put down, like major, minor, whatever, has been done before. But it's all about how you do it. So, you know, this progression right here, first of all, has probably never been done, like, in serum in this way, you know what I mean? So it's like, it's all about like how you like the rhythm of it, the rhythm combined with the harmony. Like once you kind of combine those two factors, then there's a lot of, you know, combos that haven't been done, because like when it's just like harmonics, like, okay, we're going from this chord to this chord to this chord, all of those have been done a billion times, and there's nothing wrong with using a progression that people have been using, like, you know, 1-4-5, you know, classic kind of like progressions that, you know, there's not, it's not like, it's not wrong to use progressions that are well known, but I think it's like, it's always kind of like a challenge to introduce like all the harmonic structure of it in like interesting new ways. So with this one, I made this last night, and it's like, I like the way that it jumps around, like, so this second, like when I play this first one, it does the same thing, but on the second round, like on this half, it adds a new bass note. So changing the bass note on the bottom of like all those chords completely changes the feeling of the whole thing. So something to keep in mind, you know, if you can come up with some sort of interesting like harmonic chord progression thing, do it twice, and on the second one switch up what the bass does, and it completely like, completely like, it just totally changes the vibe, because we can put like if it's a major chord on top, we can put like a minor bass note that, as long as it's in the right key, I mean, if it's in completely wrong key, it's gonna sound like garbage. Like let's figure out, like, a wrong note would be like, like, that's wrong, obviously. Like, there is a right and wrong. But there's not just one option. Like, when you're making a bass line, you know, there's definitely the root note that you can go with, which is, like, usually, like, if we're in the key of C minor or C major, the bass line is probably going to be starting on a C. But if you kind of, like, do it twice, if you do the whole progression twice, that second round, you could change the bass note to an A. And in that case, like, then you have a minor note on the bottom, and it changes your whole C major chord on top to feel way different. So just keep that in mind. Like, changing the bass note can totally switch up the whole vibe, even if the chords are the exact same. So we got some new people in the chat here. What up, Michael? Powell, watching the stream from a car. Greetings from Cologne. Where's Cologne? That's... is that France, or is that, I'm an idiot. I don't know where that is, but welcome guys. Yeah, this is the beat I started last week on the stream, and I'm just going to keep working on it. I'll stop talking for a sec and just see what else I can do. I think there's a lot going on, so it's kind of like, now my goal is to like simplify it a little bit, you know? This is the part I worked on a lot last, I mean, I did all this last night, but like, I was trying to make like a buildup that made sense, because I realized that this buildup is kind of in like 3-4. It's like 1-2-3, 1-2-3. Like the melody. So 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2. So it kind of makes the buildup a little more difficult than your average like buildup, but it actually makes it like a little more interesting. Let's see. Well, this is kind of what I came up with. I'm not fully like done with it. I like this little like stretched out tom sound. I might like play with the beat. Oops. Okay. Germany. Oops. Sorry. Cologne, Germany. Deutschland. Or Belgium. Yeah, I mean, I love that there's so many European, like 343 seems to have a lot of like a European crowd, which I love. Like, I always tell people, because I just moved to New York, like my goal is to be in New York as long as I was in LA, which is like 8 years, and then move further east, basically keep going. So hopefully I'll see you guys in Europe in the next like 7 years. I've only been here for 2 months, so you got to give me like another 7 years and 9 months in New York. And then who knows what'll happen around that time. But I mean, I think it's cool that 343 has like a place in Germany. Like, definitely super interested to get out there and meet some of the European folks I've been meeting virtually. That would be really cool. Okay, sorry, let's keep going. But yeah, making a build up in 3-4. I mean, the song is still in 4-4, but you can hear that melody is 1-2-3. Dun 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 dun. So if you did like a drum beat that was just like on 1-2-3-4, it would sound really, I tried and it sounded really weird. Like, we just watched, if I just did like, wrong thing. Like if we did this. It sounds super weird. It almost sounds like a triplet. Like this drum starts to sound like a triplet, even though it's doing like the straightforward rhythm. Okay, now let's figure this out. Yeah. I kind of want to take the vocal thing. I have it kind of in this all mids group, and I'm doing this to it, but I kind of want to just separate this out because I want this vocal thing to kind of be doing its own like thing. I don't really want it to be connected to the pads, because I think it's like just its own, like it's a more important thing. So let's take it out. Take it in over here. This is kind of like the main vocal lead. Dotted rhythm. I don't know. I think Italy. Okay, someone just said Italy. Yes, I would love to go to Italy. I've never been to Italy. Yeah, I don't know if it's dotted rhythm, because even the dotted rhythm sounds weird when I put the drum on that. Like this 3 and this 6 are both dotted rhythms. Like 3 means dotted eighth note, and 6 is a dotted quarter note. So if I did like... still doesn't really... My last night when I was figuring this out, I just figured like, I just kind of figured out like I have to just do everything by hand, because every time I threw like a delay on it, it just didn't do exactly the rhythm I wanted. So like, these are all just placed in by hand, and some of them are like off the grid, but it seems to be working. And I think like whenever you do like a big kick like that, like, I feel like it kind of needs bass to make it like... to give it like context. Otherwise, it's just like a random kick for no reason. But you don't need... I don't really want to introduce like a whole bass yet, but like... All right, so now I feel like it's like time to, I have all the elements I need, but they're kind of just laying on top of each other. So I think like this vocal thing is really cool. And I think if we're gonna like introduce it with that big like octave jump where it's like, I think we gotta just really let it breathe, and like right when it comes in, just like cut everything basically. So it's like, there's other stuff happening I can cut too, like see how, like, when you really define each part, you know, like, it's not, it's just like all the stuff that I'm doing is already done. It's just like, it's more powerful if I really accent each thing. And then, like, you know, all the stuff we're doing, I can bring in later, like, all together. Like, we can just let it ride. But I think when you first drop into something, you really just want to be, like, really clear about, like, here's what you need to pay attention to. And in this case, it's like that big vocal, that, you know, future bass synth, like boom, 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 like all that stuff. Super important to like introduce in the right way. And then once you kind of get it into people's brains, you know, then you can just stack them all on top of each other. But I think basically we gotta do it twice. See, this is cool. This is something I completely forgot about. That sounds cool. I want to use that. Instead of this. I think we need a break from this. Also, just realized there's like a there's new notes in this one that I wasn't. Oh, you guys cannot see my session. Sorry. There's new notes in this one that I wasn't using. Like, this is what it looked like before. So it's just stuff like that. You gotta like look out. That's why I like to color code stuff, so I remember like, okay, this one's slightly different. But yeah, how you guys doing? Let's talk for a second. I think I've done enough talking for a little bit. Would love to get some feedback. Like, what do you guys want to learn? What do you guys want to see? I don't know if we talked last week. I think maybe I said I would do something specific today, but I know you guys are kind of on a lag, so I'll wait for a sec. But Michael says, oh wait, who's a drummer? Oh, Josh. Josh is a drummer. He says, as a percussionist, being on the grid drives me nuts. Yeah, I like to, you know, there's, you got to pick and choose your battles with like what should be on the grid. But I do like being on the grid for very specific things. Like, I like to use it for like the kick pattern and the snare. Occasionally I'll have like a little accent kick or accent snare that's not on the grid. But I think if you do everything off the grid, it kind of gets really a little too wonky. Like, it's a little too hard to follow like what's happening. So definitely want to have some things on the grid, or at least come back to the grid. Like, you know, if you're gonna start on like the one, have that like kick drum right on the one and right on the grid, and then like you can kind of like wishy-washy it all the way through like bar four, like go from one to four and have the kick, you know, if you really want to get like wonky with it, like your kick can kind of like be off the grid a little bit throughout that four bar phrase. But the goal would be for like at the end of the four bar phrase, when you start the next phrase, you want it to feel like a loop. You want it to feel like when we land back on that fifth bar, like the next one, it feels like it's kind of like consistent. So that's just something I've realized. Like, if you want to do like really wonky kicks and snares, like as long as you kind of like edge back towards the grid, towards the end of your loop, so that like once the loop repeats, because that's the tricky part. Because if you really need, like, let's say you're like so swung that after four bars you put the kick back on the one and it's like doesn't feel right, it feels like too early, then that means you're kind of screwed, because like that means it'll never be, you'll never get back to the grid. It'll always, you'll just have to keep pushing everything further and further off the grid, and then your whole song's just gonna like lose the context of what's happening. So I think like being off the grid is cool, but make sure at some point you like loop back and kind of land back on the grids in some capacity, you know. Josh said, I mentioned remixes. Yeah. Yeah, we can do some remix stuff. Yeah, definitely need a home base on the grid. Yeah, just the grid is your friend. Like, you want to use the grid to keep an eye on where you are. Otherwise, you're just kind of like in limbo. Like, you're just not going to be able to like dance to it because it's too random, you know. Simple Sam says, also, I always seem to make only 8 bars of melody and don't know how to change it up. Tips on that would be great. Yeah, let's just start some new stuff. Yeah, remixes. I mean, the most important part of remixes is like learning how to warp really well. So like, let me see if I can just find a song. Yeah, I'll do a little. Well, before I move on, I want to re-mention for anyone that's just joining. 343 is running a Cyber Week sale, 25% off all the courses until this Sunday. So yeah, go ahead, like 343labs.com. I think, let me make sure that's the right. Hopefully that's 343labs. I want to make sure it's the right spot. Yeah, 343labs.com. 25% off all the courses until Sunday. Then you can come learn. You can come be in my actual class. You know, streams are cool, but I can't actually see your computer and I can't like dive in and help you guys with your beats as much as I could in a class. So definitely highly recommend if you can do it. I think learning like in person is always great. Or like if you guys are in other countries, like there's lots of streaming, like Zoom type of stuff as well. And they're doing a giveaway on 343 TV for 3-month membership to Splice. Okay. So keep an eye on that. I'm going to keep moving on. I just got to keep plugging the stuff I need to plug, man. This is a business. All right, let's do some remixes. Let me find a cool song to remix. I like remixing stuff that needs, that kind of like feels like it needs a remix. So not necessarily like stuff that's already like EDM-y. Like I like to remix stuff that's like more, I don't know, that like it would feel weird or feel new to have like a beat on top of. So let's see. I'm just looking through what I actually have on my computer. And I'll try and kind of answer your like Simple Sam, the melody thing. I'll try to answer that with sort of like a remix. Okay. No, not that song. These are just the songs I have on my computer. They're okay. I want to find one that I actually want to remix. Oh, this one's cool. Okay, let's look at this. I just went to a random screen from my Twitch back in the day that probably looks really funny.
I see you, baby. All
right, so step one, warp it. I'm going to just show you this like a quick warp. This is kind of like, this isn't usually how I teach warping, but like this is how I personally like to warp just because it's the fastest way. But basically just, I like to just look at the audio, like look up here, look at the grid, look where things are lining up, turn the metronome on. So right now it's like nowhere near where it needs to be. It'd be way slower. So it needs to be faster.
I see you.
And really I'm using the audio like, that needs to be the one. This is like, I know the song well enough to know that like that's the one. So I'm just going to like look at that and like see where I can move the BPM so that that lines up. Boom, 88. That's it. I just used my visual like reference. And now when I click play, it should sound right.
I see you, baby.
Sounds good to me. So warp. 88, step 1.1, warp 88 from here. Let's go put a couple warp markers down. Oops. Do a double check real quick with the metronome. All you wanna do is just slap. And I'm just looking for whole numbers. Carmilla Camila Cabello. Yeah, that's, he's a good one to remix. I mean, this kind of song, like, I honestly just, like, I love that it has this intro, because this intro would be fun to produce around just by itself. Okay, so, yeah, Remix 101, I think, like, step one, do a really good warp. I think this warp is pretty good. And then you can always, like, tweak it more later. We can, like, I think this is my first December beat. So let's see what it would sound like at just different speeds.
Just say.
for bad bitch. Compliment your swag with bad bitch. I don't spend too much time without my savages. So fuck it, brought the rollies for my savage. Hey, buy bad for bad bitch.
So usually I just find a spot that I really like. Like this case, I like this part of the song. I already sped it up 12 dB faster than it was. And I feel like one thing that's just really cool to do is just if it's a hip hop song, you know, make it hot house, or if it's a house song, make it hip hop. You know what I mean? Like do the opposite of what it is. But not completely necessary, but I think that's just like a good technique. Like, I think that like this song would be cool to have a house remix of it, so I'm gonna see if I can make like a housey.
Hey, buy bad for bad bitch. Compliment you. Hey, buy bad for bad bitch. Compliment your swag with bad bitch. I don't spend too much time without my savages. So fuck it, brought the rollies for my savages. In the photo, Bentley truck, just us. I treat it like a cool damn, what the fuck? Walk in the club, savage to the front, savage to the back. Got my savage homie, you know what? Hey, buy bad for bad bitch. Compliment your swag with bad bitch. I don't spend too much time without my savages. So fuck it, brought the rollies for my savages. In the photo, I treat it like a cool damn, what the fuck? Walk in the club, savage to the front, savage to the back. Come on, savage, homie, you know what? Hey, buy bad for bad bitch.
All right, cool. So I got like a little pattern going. One thing I might want to do just to save time is take the harmony from the intro, because it's just going to give me like an idea of like the structure of the chords. And like, I'm going to have to clean it up for sure, but you know what? I just realized the intro is different than the beginning of the song. There we go. That's a lot better. Okay. Definitely some wrong notes, but for the most part. Cool, those are pretty good. I like this new little note that it added. Okay, so that's the gist of it. And the reason I wanted to get that is I just kind of want the information of like the basic chords of it, but I think that should be. I do like that there's something kind of like new at the end, but We'll deal with that later. I think I mostly just want this bass line. So let's take this over here. Cool. So that's like the chords. If I decide to do some sort of like pad thing, let's figure out the bass line just by itself. So we basically just delete everything that's not another serum here. Serum is just kind of my go-to like plugin that I use for synth stuff. I'm just used to it. I think Massive is also cool. I just never really got super used to Massive, but just a little switch up could be cool. If I've asked you, but have you used Deezer to extract stems for remix purposes, Dane? Mr. Bill's partner created it. No, I haven't. I know there's definitely a lot of cool things out there to get stems or acapellas, like to extract them. I guess what I'm kind of teaching you guys right now is like more of like a bootleg. So it's like just kind of like using the overall track to do it. You know what I mean? Like, this is kind of just like one style of remix. I could have maybe just at least given it a quick Google search to see if there to see if there was stems for this, or see if there was an acapella. Sometimes I'll start the process like this. Like, I'll start with the full track, and then I will, like, you know, if I find the stems later, I'll just replace it with the acapella. But this is kind of like just a really fun way to just kind of start. You know what I mean? Like, I think there's a lot of ways to like slow yourself down and be like, oh, let's spend all day trying to find the stems. And it's like, could just start working on the song. You know what I mean? So, you know, nothing wrong with finding great stems, but I think for me, it's like more of an exercise. Like, I'm just trying to like get to the point and like start writing. And like, some songs are easier to remix than others, like this one. Like, the problem that I'm gonna run into is that like mid-level kick. Like, you can hear it right there. Because that like hip-hop kick is not hitting at the same time as the house kick. So here, actually, I gotta hit the bathroom real quick. I'm gonna give me like literally 30 seconds. Okay, we back. Sorry about that. Cool. All right, let's get to it. Let me just keep going here. Let me see if I missed anything. Spleeter from Deezer. Okay, cool. Yeah, I'll look that up. I think that sounds fun. Yeah, and there's also like that new Kanye one that supposedly does it. I've seen some reviews that's like it kind of like does the same thing as other plugins, but all right, I'm just gonna keep working. See, this is like slowing me down. Just talking about the potential to have stems has slowed me down. So let's work on the music actually. So, you know, I'm kind of just building like the most turned up version of the beat. I'm not saying it'll necessarily go right here in the song, but I'm kind of just using this part of the song to write to. With that said, let's make, you know. That's pretty cool. An idea. I just have like an idea for a melody that would be cool on like a I'm gonna tune it so it's in the right key. Put a minor scale on it too to really try don't mess up. Oh. Thank you. cool. You know, it sounded pretty cool. I think, you know, I might end up putting in some 808s, so it's not like, I think that synth bass is cool, but still not gonna like hit the way that like a, like we can just probably EQ out the synth so that it feels like the bass, but we actually have more of like a subby bass. What's the actual bass doing? Bass is doing. I'm gonna put this near the bass so we can look at it. Last thing I'll do is before we leave is just give this bass some more personality. If you guys have any last minute questions or anything, throw them in the chat now. I'm gonna wrap up in a couple minutes, but yeah, this sounds cool. I think this is like definitely a nice little window into like how I would start a remix. I didn't really get too much into melodies, so Martin, if you come next time, we can focus more on that. You know, it's similar to what I've been saying, you know, like write a pattern that's kind of repetitive and then like have it kind of evolve over time. But thank you. Cool. So everything we just did, we'll put into a chain. And then we'll just make another chain that doesn't do that. So this is like the mid levels. I've shown you guys this before, but this is like kind of like my go subs. Now I just have this subby one. Cool. Yeah, that's just a little basic remix intro thing. You know, most important stuff I did was warp it really well. That's like number one thing, is make sure it's warped well. And you know, when it's warped well, we can take everything we've done and be like, actually, this needs to be faster. But if it's not warped well, then you kind of have to start, like, that's just the most important thing to get right from the beginning. After that, you know, cut the basses, add your own kick, add your own bass, sidechain it, and you can really make, even like a full song like this, you can make it feel like it's like fully your remix. So, you know, we can do more on it next week, or you know, we can keep going. Or like, remixing is basically like the art of just like producing around something that already exists, which I think is a great way to learn how to produce, because you get like a guideline. You don't have to just write a song from scratch. You can just kind of produce something that's already has a skeleton. But let me see. Those drums are sick. Gonna practice some of these tips tonight. Yeah, go for it, Josh. I will remember. I won't call you Roger next week. But yeah, just before we go, let me just one more plug. There's a sale. I lost my thing here, but I said it a couple times. Just look out for that sale. Definitely sign up for some classes. I would love to meet some of you guys in person, or, you know, more one-on-one stuff, on Zoom, if you're into that, because then I get to look at your projects and, we can go deeper than just, you know, me just showing you general tips and tricks. But yeah, I'll see you guys next week, and it's been a pleasure. Hopefully, you learned something. I'll see you later.